Good evening, students. So now we will start a grammar portion of true sentence and phrases. So sentences, you must have heard about it. Means you make sentence daily when you speak in English, make sentences. You must have writing the sentences from the earlier classes. Here I want to explore this thing by explaining what is a sentence and how it's different from the phrases. The other one is the phrases. How they both are different. So sentence is a, so before going into detail of sentences, I would like to just throw us a little bit of light on the two words that are letter and words. Words itself. Letter means, we all know, A to Z. There are 26 alphabets. A to Z. And with the combining the letters, by combining the letters, we form the words. Words we can say like am is a word, cat is a word, dog is a word, and we can form other words as well. So we know that what are letters, we know what are words. So sentence is nothing different from the letters, from the words. Sentences are formed by the grouping of words itself. How we group the words? This is the most important thing when we study about the sentences. Words formed or words arranged in a group together and then after arranged in a proper manner to us to give a proper meaning forms the sentence. That is the complete and a true and a correct meaning of a sentence. So how we can say that how the words are being arranged? So there are some basic points, there are some basic requirements which need to be fulfilled at the time of the formation of sentence and the time of the reading of the sentence, whether a particular sentence is correct or not. It can be solved, this particular theory can be solved only and only with have a proper knowledge of the sentence. The basic points which are, first one is capital letter. Capital letter. So we all know what is capital letter. Which the capital letter two types, in small letter and capital letter. So this is the basic requirement. A sentence always begins with capital letter. Begins with capital letter. This is the first requirement. Whenever we start a sentence, whenever we frame the sentences, it should always begin with a capital letter. Which means that the first letter should always be the capital one. After that, second one being proper ending should be there. Proper ending. So, what do you mean by the proper ending? What do we mean by the proper ending? Proper ending means that it should end with either with a, it should end with a punctuation mark. That is important here. Punctuation mark is needed. That is, it can either be a full stop, it can be a question mark, or it can be a exclamation mark. So, whether to put, where to put question mark, where to put full stop, where to put exclamation mark, how will you classify, how will you know, able to know? So depending upon the type of the sentences, we will be knowing and we will be giving these punctuation mark. If it is an assertive or a declarative sentence, simply we will give the full stop. If it is a question sentence, which means if it's an interrogative sentence, so we will give a, end it with a question mark. You all know the question mark like this, full stop like this. And if it is beginning or if it is an exclamatory sentence showing some kind of exclamation, then it will end with a exclamation mark like this. So this is the basic requirement. Two requirements we have seen. Third one is proper grouping of words. Proper grouping of words. What do you mean of proper grouping of words? Proper grouping of words, which means that words should be arranged in a proper order so that it should give a proper and a complete meaning. It should give a complete sense. Sense here meaning is that for the words, if are arranged in a proper manner, we will be able to know what the sentence means to say. Like example, if I am saying boy is Ram, are we able to understand? No, because the words are not arranged properly. But if I am saying Ram is a boy, so we can able to understand that ki Ram ek ladka hai. So, humne yahan pe jab words ko ek proper arrangement kiya in a proper manner, then after a sentence, a proper and a correct sentence will be formed. So, that is the another basic requirement of a formation of a sentences. So, if we combine all these points, so we can say that a proper definition will be a sentence is a, just pay attention, a sentence is a proper group arrangement of the group of words with a correct meaning. Adding to it, we can say it begins with a capital letter and it wins again and it ends with a punctuation mark. That can be a question mark, it can be a full stop, it can be a exclamation mark. And sentence also has, most of the sentence almost have a verb in it. Verb, what is? It's an action word. We will just be having a different we will be having a separate class about verbs, so don't worry about that. Just it's just a brief that a sentence also has a verb in it. So this is all about the sentence. We will come up with the next classes, other classes with the examples of sentence to have a better explanation, to have a better clear, so that the things become more and more clear to you. Just brief about phrases. Phrases are different from the sentence. How? Phrase is just a part of sentence. Phrase is just a part. In what sense it is a part? Is it made up of numbers? No. It is also formed by the words. As the sentence is formed by the words, phrases are also formed by the words. What is the difference? The basic difference is that it has no proper meaning. Phrases has no proper meaning. It doesn't give any complete sense. Why the sense is not complete? The thing can be that the words may not be arranged properly, or it also, the thing which is most important in the phrases is that it has no proper beginning and no proper ending. It has no proper beginning and no proper ending. Sentence has a proper beginning with a capital letter, and phrases has no proper beginning. Means the it can start with a capital, will not start with a capital letter, it can start with a small letter. As example, if I am writing that this place is very nice, no capital letter over here and no punctuation mark in the end. I am not giving any punctuation mark over here. So this is the phrase. This is the basic difference between the sentences and the phrases, that sentence will give a proper meaning. Phrases is just a part of a sentence with no proper beginning, with no and no proper ending. This is the basic difference between the two. And you must be having your textbook with yourself of grammar. Just open up the chapter number 2 and just go through the examples. You will be able to understand more and more clearly. Just have a look at this, at this video, at this class, listen to it, and after that go to your textbook, go through the different questions are there, examples have been given, so that you can identify, you can clarify the things properly. And after that, I will like to tell you that just after that, try to solve the objectives as well. If you are not able to do, I don't think that there will be any that much of difficulty that you are not able to do, but if there will be any difficulty, that will be sorted out later. I will come up with the classes, with examples as well, so that the things become more and more clear to you. Just, but at this point of time, having this class and having, listening to me, whatever I'm saying, just for once at least, open up the book, open up the chapter number 2, that is the sentence and phrases, read the points which have been given, because I am not teaching you anything apart from a book. It's all about in your syllabus. Just go through the chapter, read the sentences, and mostly the examples, so that you can understand the difference between the two. I will come with the next classes. Until then, see you. Goodbye.